In 1995, Atari Games unveiled Area 51, the incredible story behind the most closely guarded military base in the world.
Okay. I'm Hector Silva, and I was part of a four-man team that created Area 51. Back in 1992, I believe, and I worked for Mesa Logic, and we had a contract to do three games for Atari, and Area 51 was the first one, and I believe it was Robert Weatherby and his brother-in-law, which escapes my name, that came up with the idea, and they were both programmers, and they hired us as graphics artists to come up with the graphics, and this is Area 51. Which is the PC version, and this is, what is this, Tips and Tricks. Here's where we were featured on the cover, and what else we got? Popular Mechanics had a nice article on Area 51, and here's another one, Popular Mechanics, Area 51. So I kept those magazines, because Area 51 was a secret base, but you know, we took... There was a kind of a Google Earth map that we found in the magazine, and I took that and I just traced it with AutoCAD and created the whole base. I was the head modeler, and I just created the entire environment of the hangar and the war room, the headquarters, and a lot of the modeling that we use, like the tanks and the trucks. We bought those off the shelf.
Come on! Stay low!
So here's some of the memorabilia that I kept. Here's the first Tiger game for Area 51. It's a little dusty here. And never been opened! But there it is. I don't even know how it plays because I've never opened it, but we were given these. We're also given a couple of things like this Area 51 box. The truth is in there. And they gave us this memorial barrel to shoot. Okay, so it's just a ceramic deal. That's kind of cool. Here's some of the actual Area 51 tags that they gave out at the first show, and some little emblems, little brooches, I don't know what to call these, pins, Area 51 pins, there's a couple of them there. So I got those, and I'm going to give one of those to Scott, and then I've got this little alien guy in the bottle. Yeah, that's where I keep him inside this. And when I do presentations for schools, I take this with me, and it really freaks out the kids. So this is kind of cool. And then I've got, let's see, there's this photo of that we took for the game. You'll see that on the game when you first see the credits. And that's going to be James, Jim, Fumo, Hector. That's the team. Okay. And this is, what is this? Some kind of brochure that we gave out at the show talking about Area 51. Okay, forgot about this. And here's my name tag. Time Warner, Atari Games, Interactive, Exhibitor Member. And I forget, we did this show in New Orleans, and it's called AMOA. That was where we first presented the game. That was kind of neat. And then here's some Area 51. What is this? Oh, it was a kit that you could buy and build flying saucers. And so this is just the instructions and a little bit about, what's his name, Robert Lazar. He was big and he was a big fan of Area 51. All right, here you go. This was presented to the Area 51 team by Mesa Logic. So it's kind of a high school looking thing, and there's the name Mesa Logic, and there's the back of the jacket, Area 51. So there's only 4, 5, 6, 7, I think there's only 7 of these jackets around that were made.
Well, Scott, back when we were wrapping up the game, turned out we had some extra room on the hard drive, or extra RAM, actually, that we could put some more graphics in, but we couldn't animate it. It just had to be a still. And that's when we came up with the secret rooms. So each one of us, myself, James, Jim, and Fumo, we each came up with a secret room. Mine's the one with the, it was done in the nuclear facility, and it had like eggs floating and green stuff, and that when you shot them, you saw the baby aliens. And Fumo did the one with Buddha heads, which was eventually taken out because of the Asian market. They didn't want their Buddha being shot at, so that one came out, and I forget what they replaced it with. Jim did the one with the guys in the bathroom urinating. The aliens were urinating, and you shot them as they were urinating. And there was one more done by James, and I don't remember what that was. But anyway, that's an interesting story, because they were, when the game first shipped out, it shipped out all over the United States and Asia. And Asia wouldn't buy them because of the Buddha in the secret room. And so we have to recall all those games and reissue a new game without the Buddha room. And so there's actually 2 different versions of the game out there.
Tripwire, get this.
Yeah, I think, what is it, Mario's secret hiding place is the last level. I used to get there so easy. I don't know if I can do it anymore. Got him. There we go. I'm starting to remember the pattern.